Good morning, Mabuhay Squad.
Alright, so it's morning and it's time to check the mouse trap to see if we caught it. Let's do this, Mabuhay Squad. OMG!
Hey guys, welcome to my daily vlogs. Please subscribe.
We didn't catch it, but look, it managed to somehow eat the little crumbs that I put in there. Oh no, sorry. The crumbs were taken away by ants.
Okay guys, so it looks like we didn't catch this mouse. Maybe the mouse is smart. It smells my scent all over the trap. It's weary about the trap, does not want to step inside it. I don't know. We're gonna try to use a different bait, maybe. Or possibly try to set it up downstairs tonight. Oh dear.
Good morning.
Morning, guys.
Did you sleep well?
Let's start the day off right, guys, with our positive affirmation of the day. So Friday, June the 5th. I choose to stretch beyond where I was when I got up this morning. I am ready to open myself to something new.
Amazing! There you go.
That is the definition of growth, I would imagine. Hope you enjoyed today's positive affirmation, guys. Now guys, this morning is gonna be a little different. That's kind of why I'm wearing a Hawaiian shirt. Just something I saw in my closet that I was like, okay, I need to put this on. Because I'm about to meet some high school friends on Zoom. And I don't know who's attending, but it was organized by my friend Lawrence, who, by the way, is one of those guys that is like the best at keeping in touch, like over time. You know what I mean? Like, you know how some people just have the knack or a talent in keeping in touch with people? Like, after how many years has it been? I was class of 2000. OMG. It's been over 20 years, guys, and I haven't talked to some of these people since, like, literally since high school. So it's gonna be a sort of high school mini reunion of friends. So that's gonna happen in a couple minutes. I was like, oh, man, should I do my, like, should I style my hair? Nah. You guys see me at my worst. I mean, my hair could be worse than this. Natural is better, right? Let's have some coffee. Here we go. All right, Mabuhay Squad, I'd like you to meet some people. Okay, so you guys know Lawrence Lam. This is Lawrence, yeah? From Seattle. We have Vincent Key from Oakville. We have Pat Rowe from Waterloo. Well, these two are still in Ontario. Lawrence, of course, is in Seattle. Go check out that vlog. And we're just hanging out. Good to see you guys after all these years. It's been 20 years. Yeah, it's really, really awesome catching up with them. They've got families and stuff.
The guy, yes. Guys, you know, wanna say something I noticed about the way this alignment of the perches is here. Look, normally, as you guys know, wait, this thumb over here has kind of like a deformity or a problem. It like faces forward or just like lays on top instead of gripping from behind, because parrots are supposed to have two toes in front, two toes behind. Like this one is okay. Okay, see, now she's doing the incorrect way. But because of the alignment of this perch, it kind of forces the back toe to go backwards, which is great, because I think the more she does it, the more it'll properly fix itself over time. That's what I think. So good, the guysies. I hope so anyway. See, it's almost like rehabilitating that toe. Both of them, actually. Both of them used to be incorrect, but this one sort of fixed itself over time. I'm hoping this one does too. Someone was asking for a shower. I saw her trying to bathe in her water bowl again. So she's getting a shower. Shower, shower, shower. Shower, 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 shower. Go and get that little shower. Yep, there you go.
Okay, I think she wants me to stop now.
All right, I get it.
All right, guys, so after thinking about it for a while, I decided, you know what, we should probably just keep this here for at least a couple more nights, because maybe the mice are just weary of it, because, like, I'm assuming they've been living in this room now for a few days, and they know what's new and what isn't new. So they're probably just very weary of it. Like, it's just some new contraption that smells like humans, and it's just sitting there. So they're probably, like, not coming close to it, but I think they just need to become accustomed first to it being around before they consider actually stepping into this device. That's my guess. I mean, look at Legaia. It takes her a while to warm up to something, so I suspect that the mouse or mice here in the ant room are just weary to approach it because it's all of a sudden this new thing here in the ant room. So I'm just gonna leave it here for a couple of days and see if we catch anything. Gonna keep my eye open for a better bait. If you guys have any suggestions for bait that we could use, let me know in the comments. Like, for me, a cracker with peanut butter was the best. Here they won't eat cheese, apparently, but let's just keep this here and see if it works.
OMG guys, you won't believe what just arrived. It's a loot box! See this? Oh, but what's inside the box is awesome. Oh my gosh, guys. Let me open it. Oh, guys. So a couple days ago, I saw a YouTube video of a Filipino aquarium YouTuber. And I saw that he had bought like a mono shrimp and various like aquascaping things. And I'm like, OMG, where did you get that? And he told me and introduced me to this fellow online named Anton Lazatin. Yes. So guys, he works for this company called Arrow One Corp. Now, Anton Lazatin and the company he works with is pretty incredible. They have everything, anything aquascaping. They've got plants, they've got fish, they've got gear, like tech gear, filters, lighting, incredible. So I contacted him and I got all the stuff I needed. Check out my package.
OMG, OMG. Okay, so let's grab this first. This here, oh, awesome, yay. So this is a local guy. I believe his name is Ed Cruz, and he creates these fertilizers for planted tanks. Yay, so I've got my macros, which is nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. Chelated micronutrients, so here are the micronutrients. And here's iron and potassium. OMG, this is awesome. Oh, and this has magnesium too. Oh my gosh, this is exactly what I need. Ah! Okay, I'm gonna use this today on my plants. Let's see what else. Oh my gosh, look guys. Oh, now these, they're called horned nerite snails. Clethon corona. Clethon corona. I don't know if you can see them, but they're basically snails that have these little horns. And they apparently are some of the best algae eating snails available. Like all the YouTube, the professional aquascapers use them. See, they're right there. They're at the bottom. It's hard to show you guys though. See them guys? See them in there? You got those little spikes. Oh my gosh, I can't wait. Awesome. I have Clethon corona. Ah! Okay, next. What else is there here? These plants I've been looking everywhere for. Oh, Tripartita. Oh, and what is this? Okay, these are like extras. Oh my gosh, thank you. That's awesome. I never ordered this, but hey, free is cool. Awesome. Thank you so much, Anton. Wow. All right. No, that's not what I wanted to show you. Here, okay, here. Guys, look at this. Ricardia moss. I've been looking all over for it. I can't wait to grow this on the wood. That's gonna look awesome. Awesome. Ooh!
Love Ricardia moss!
And this, guys, look at how gorgeous this plant is. This here is the beautiful plant known as Hygrophila pinnifetida. It's awesome! It looks like a fern, and it grows on wood and rocks. It's an epiphyte, and so I can't wait to grow this on some of the wood in my... This will be perfect in my meadow-themed tank, because it looks like ferns.
Ooh, I can't believe I have it!
So awesome, and the Ricardia moss, can't wait to introduce it! That will be the fourth species of moss I will have in my planted tank. Yay! Okay, guys, look. Look what else! Look what else! Check this beautiful out. Guys, I'd like to introduce to you the beautiful plant known as Buse Philandra. It's also an epiphyte plant, but it is so beautiful. The leaves are so gorgeous. They're kind of like an olive slash reddish brown color. It's a slow growing plant. It grows on rocks, but I'm gonna try to attach it on some wood and maybe some rocks too. And it is so gorgeous, this plant. Oh my gosh. See, it's all one plant and I could separate them and plant them separately and attach with rubber bands or like fishing wire and just let it grow. Oh, I can't wait to introduce this small growing plant in my tank. Buse Philandra. And then there's this one. Oh my gosh, so cool. Miniature Buse Philandra. Look how tiny they are. They're so cute. This will be so fun to like attach. This is for detailing, like for baby Buse Philandras that I can attach to various places. OMG, this is gonna be so, so fun to aquascape, guys. I cannot wait.
Woo!
And so guys, if you need anything aquascaping related, lighting, filters, fish, any kind of aquarium plant you might have seen on a YouTube video, be sure to contact Anton Lazatin on Facebook.
Yes.
Oh, also fertilizers for days. He's got all the fertilizers, all the different things you need for tanks. He carries like Seachem, all of those Aqua Tropica. I don't know where, just contact him. He's got everything. If you want to get into aquascaping, he's so helpful. He's helped me understand more about aquascaping. I had so many questions. And I can't wait to use these fertilizers and start aquascaping today. Oh, I am going to be so wet today working on my tank. Can't wait. OMG guys, I can't wait to show this tank to you when I'm done. So I'm gonna work on it now. I'm excited to get started. I was curious guys, if any of you guys have like a very remote hobby that you're really passionate about. I'm curious to know because there are a lot of people out there with some very unique hobbies, very intensive unique hobbies that require like a lot of knowledge and skill, you know, like aquascaping. So share your hobby and be proud.
Yes.
But before I start, I heard a noise. I wonder if it was the mouse trap.
Let's check. Mabuhay squad.
OMG! Ah! Check it out.